Hey guys, because over here and this is Yachinas. Guys, today again I'm with you to run around Arduino. We'll see how to connect 16x2 LCD with Arduino by using MCP2308 port expander and Adafruit LCD backpack library. So for this tutorial actually we are going to use MCP2308 only, but if you are like interested in other port expander IC, you can use that as well. Just it need to have digital IOs on that IC. So actually you may ask why it is required, because as you know, when connecting LCD or the 16x2 LCD with the Arduino or any microcontroller, it takes up to 6 or 10 pins of your microcontroller depending upon the mode you are running the LCD. Like if you are running in 4-bit mode, it takes 6 pins, and if you are running in 8-bit mode, it takes 10 pins. To save those precious pins of your microcontroller, you can use this kind of I2C or SPI based port expander with your Arduino or any microcontroller to use external LCD. So it also helps in one more thing, like you don't need to connect much more wire again from your Arduino to the LCD. Just you need to take two wires or three wires depending upon the IC or the port expander you are using to the LCD, and the IC or the PCB will get fitted to the LCD only. So over here in this particular tutorial, I'm going to use MCP2308. So let's check it out, guys.
So guys, over here this is a circuit that we need to connect the 16x2 LCD to Arduino by using the MCP2308. So actually this is the standard MCP2308 connection that I am using over here. If you are new to this, you can check out my earlier tutorial around MCP2308 with Arduino. I have just given the link down below so that you can check out the particular tutorial. So apart from this circuit, actually I have connected the 16x2 LCD to the exposed GPIO of MCP2308. So over here in LCD, the first pin, the contrast pin and the RW pin are connected to ground. So the first common ground pin, the GO pin which corresponds to actually the contrast pin of the 16x2 LCD is permanently connected to ground. So if you like are interested to control the contrast of the particular LCD, you can connect to it to a potentiometer between VCC and ground, and can just pull out the middle pin of the potentiometer to the V0 pin. And as we are using a 16x2 LCD and normally we do the write operation, I can just pull down the RW pin to ground. So either you can just connect it to any other pin of your microcontroller, it's having no issue if you connect it to the ground. The second pin goes to VCC, that is the supply for the LCD. Then we have connected the RS enable DB4, 5, 6, 7 pins to the MCP2308. So actually over here, this is a standard connection that is used in your Adafruit LCD backpack actually, because over here I am going to use the Adafruit library for the I2C LCD connection actually. This connection may change depending upon the library you are using. So over here the LCD is configured in 4-bit mode. That's why you are going to connect the upper 4-bit or upper 4 pins of the data pins to the MCP2308 only. So it goes like this: the GP1 is connected to RS, GP2 is connected to enable, and the rest of the pins goes on like that. So that's all with this circuit. So let's get back to connecting the MCP2308, the LCD and everything else to the Arduino. So after that we'll get back to the IDE and we'll download the Adafruit library for the LCD backpack, and we are going to run some demo code on our Arduino.
So as over here I have finished the connections between the Arduino the LCD and the MCP 23008. So you can see over here I have got just taken two wires for communication to the MCP 23008 and two wires for power for the MCP 23008 as well as the LCD. And the LCD is totally connected to the MCP 23008 only. So that's all with the connections. Let's get back to the IDE and just run a demo program to test out if this works.
So guys, we have connected our MCP 23008 and LCD to the Arduino. Now let's start with coding and we'll put a actual demo program so that it will print some hello world into our LCD. So for this we are going to need the Adafruit Backpack LCD library. So to download that, I've just given a link down below to go to the download page. So in this particular page, this is like submitted by Falcon 4, that is high performance LCD library for ITC backup module. Navigate to the end of the page and over here you just need to download this Liquid TWI 1.5.1 chip. Okay, so click it and it will download something like Liquid TWI 1.5.1.zip. So now we need to include this particular library to the Arduino IDE. So to do that, you can use any method that you are familiar with, like you can directly copy the unzip files into the library folder, or you can use under sketch input library. Over here, go to add.zip library and navigate to your particular file. That is in our case, that is this particular file Liquid TWI 1.5.1.zip. Just navigate to it and just click on open. So this will include the particular library to our Arduino. So under file, now whenever you open up example, you should see something like Liquid TWI 1.5.1. Okay, and over here select the Hello World I2C sketch. And this is actually a demo program that will write Hello World and the time it has been up or the Arduino has been up into the LCD. So this is nothing but the standard include error lines. Then this one, Liquid TWI LCD 0 starts the LCD or the MCP 23008 considering the address of the particular chip is 0x20. It as 2 is constant or it is always, it has taken 0 only. So the library understands that the address you have to change is 0x20. So if you have changed your A0A1A2 pin connection of your MCP 23008, you can change the address over here. So you just need to mention the last or the LSB of your address only. Okay, then LCD begin and LCD print. These functions are actually similar to whatever present in our Liquid Crystal library, that is provided to use the 16x2 LCD by default to the Arduino by using the GPIO pins. Okay, so if you have not checked those, you can check it over here under Liquid Crystal. You can check different examples over here. So all those functions are defined in this particular library when you are using MCP. Or if you are not using, you are using direct GPIO, you can use the Liquid Crystal library. So this is nothing but like LCD set cursor. This will set the cursor to the second line and the first cell, and it will print the millisecond by 1000, that is nothing but the second that the Arduino has been off. And this LCD set backlit makes the backlit on and off, but in our case we have not connected the backlit LED to our MCP 23008. Okay, so we can just omit this function over here and upload this particular sketch to the Arduino. Upload, and the sketch has been uploaded to the Arduino, and let's check the LCD if it has printed Hello World as well as the time. Okay,
so over here I have just put the demo code onto the Arduino and it can see it has printed Hello World as well as the time or millisecond that it has been up onto the LCD.
So So guys, as you saw, the LCD has successfully printed Hello World and the time. So that's all with this example. So if you want to explore by yourself the different other functions available in the library, you can just open up the particular extracted folder or the Liquid CWA 1.5.1. Just extract it, navigate inside it, and open up the liquidcwa.cpp file with any text editor. And over here, inside the file, you can see the different functions available. Like, if you want to give you a custom command, you can use the command. Then create care. If you are using custom characters, then all those functions like auto scroll, right to left, left to right, all those are available with this library. So you just need to explore it by yourself. I'm not going to cover all those in this particular episode. So that's all guys. That's all with this. Thank you. Thanks for watching.
Hey guys, it's me once again, and hope you have liked my video. If so, just hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, there is a thumbs down button for you also. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for latest updates. Okay, see you next time with my new content. That's all guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.